it looks like a Mew. That's interesting from Tyler. So this could be Nightmarsh with Mew, who we haven't seen in a while. Mew is going to be able to copy any Pokemon's attack, is the ability. And Azul has a Shaymin start, and is not going first, so we're not going to see that turn one Vileplume lockout.
Mew is only played in... Oh boy.
Is it not?
It's Wob.
Oh,
it's
my
Excelgor
goodness. I saw
Wob.
Musharna.
Unfortunately, this is lopsided to Tyler. I know this matchup well.
Oh, really?
Well, Tyler plays four Wobbuffet.
Right.
And Wobbuffet will always be active.
Oh, yeah, this was your deck for the day, right?
This was my deck, yes.
If
I play
Rob's play for the day.
I gave it to a junior, and the junior is currently 3-0.
Wow. And Tyler's 3-0 with it, too.
And Tyler's 3-0, too. I just think it was a safe play today because of...
I remember I used to play this deck. Like, I tried playing it at a couple events. Like, stuff can go horribly, horribly wrong, right? You can... I remember a game I prized 3 DCE, and you cannot win.
Well, I would like to see his list, because obviously I've put... No,
right, the
I
list
understand.
Would be good.
No, 3 DCE is fine, because you can run off of 1 DCE. Don't forget, it goes back into your deck each time, and it's
hidden. Tough to keep the lock going, though, when that kind of thing happens. So I think, like, the deck can sort of stumble a little bit if it's in the beginning of the game, but once the lock gets up and going, it's pretty much unbeatable.
Well, because I know this matchup, Tyler needs to not put down Muna.
Mm-hmm.
And if he puts down Muna and not evolve it to Musharna,
right,
that will let Azul get back into the game.
Right.
Three retreat on Musharna.
Yeah, that's
he can't get
much,
back
yeah.
into Wobbuffet. He has no trainers.
Right. So he's got the Muna in his hand. Is he gonna follow your advice? Oh, he's going to bench it. So there it goes. Muna's on the bench. Along with another Shelmet.
Muna actually has an ability that you can flip a coin if heads your opponent's asleep, if tails you're asleep.
Yes,
so you can actually stall.
Asleep. Yeah, exactly.
When you miss your DC, that's a common play. Right.
And remind us what Musharna's ability. Muna evolves into Musharna, who also has a pertinent ability.
Basically, you look at the top two cards of your deck, and you get to choose one of them to put in your hand.
Oh, that is so good.
It does not seem like a lot compared to,
but it is so much.
these 13
the
card colorises.
The fact that you get to put it in your hand, though,
that's
every
right.
turn.
Every turn.
It's really good.
And Wob doesn't stop it because he is
a psychic
Pokemon type. And, while everyone else's abilities are turned off, he's still got his
right.
only abilities still working.
That's very true. And Mew. So Wobbuffet actually would not affect this deck in the slightest.
The Shaymin that's on board, it's common for them to run one, but not two. And Mew EX, when needed, can just Sky Return.
Definitely, get that off the board.
And get that, keep the DC in hand.
Definitely,
right? And
that's
sometimes
true.
The math works out. Where you can get your opponent to die
Tyler
back into your
Tyler just revealed
turn.
A card in his hand by accident. He's shaking his head. He revealed the Hex Maniacs.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, he just shoved it on the table. That kind of stuff happens.
He definitely doesn't want to play Hex Maniac with Mew.
Nobody. He also doesn't want Azul to know anything that's in his hand.
I would really like to see these deck lists.
I would too, and I'd also like to see what's in his hand. Like, Azul's got a grass. That's not the best.
Well, Azul...
Oh, my goodness. I think Azul's hand is completely dead.
Azul,
oh,
I was going to say, he's at least didn't have Wobbuffet, and unfortunately, he didn't have the cards to get going.
Right. He had nothing. He had only a Lissandre. There was, like, an AZ in his hand that I saw. And Tyler's going to get...
If that's the case, what is in there?
An AZ, a Gloom, and another Lissandre, maybe?
Then a deck and cover here could mean game.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, if Azul doesn't top deck something to get out of this,
right,
it could be ugly. Tyler.
I mean, if that happens, Azul will just scoop and go to the next game.
Even going to take a chance. He's retreating with the DCE, even though he carries four float stones,
right.
Like it's standard in there.
Yeah, but he knows Azul's hand is not got anything going on.
Yeah, all two DCEs is enough for this deck to run over and over.
He's already got the DCE on the Mew, so he's doing
that's
the deck
right.
and cover either way.
Yes, and he's got the evolved Excelgor.
Yep, which is pretty much all you need.
He's still got to, just in case Azul gets out of this, he's still got to get his stuff in
order. Definitely. He got an Ultra Ball, so you said you don't think he plays another Shaman, though. His hand might be dead now as
One Shaman's usually you run because you run Masharna, right?
But he can Sky Return the Mew instead of deck and cover, and then he can put the DCE on the Shaman next turn and Sky Return the Shaman to draw more if he has to. Because he has a dead hand right now. See, he has... Oh, he has another Shaman.
Oh, he's got
another
Shaman right there. Okay. Yeah, all right, fair enough.
Okay, but he has 5 bench Pokemon. But once he decks and covers, he won't, so... So deck and cover is going to bring Mew... He's going to put Mew back in the deck.
He's getting Masharna out.
Against Rob's advice.
Well, it's a little different. Against the Decidueye, they'll just Lysander that.
Right.
And they'll just pick you apart on your bench, and it's over. But I guess against Lurannis has to knock it out, right?
So it's probably a little bit more safe.
It's probably a little more safe. I jumped to conclusions.
Oh, he gets an... Oh, he doesn't want
the muscle band?
Yeah,
he's got the muscle band.
Probably will go for the muscle band.
So deck and cover is 50 damage plus poison. Yeah, because he didn't have any draw cards in hand.
He didn't, but he does have Shaman, so he can just deck and cover and play Shaman.
No, he can't get Wobbuffet back. Right?
Oh, you're right. If he sends up, he could have not sent up Wobbuffet.
He doesn't want to end. Unless he knows he can get this knockout.
But he should... I mean, he knows Azul's hand is also dead, so... Unless he thinks he's keeping something in there. I think Azul would have gone for the Vileplume if he had anything.
He's still got the Masharna Forewarn to... check the top two cards.
And here he's going to go stalling the Masharna.
And he passes.
Right. So this could be
damage.
Very short.
Well, that's good because the Shaman now works.
If Tyler can find a way to get this Masharna out of the active and get the DCE.
Yeah, he does. He's going to Ultra Ball his hand away and then he's going to Shaman.
That's why I sort of like promoting the Excelgore.
Floatstone
and
DCE.
And taking the... muscle band, but of course we know Azul's hand, Tyler doesn't, so there's a lot more we can say about it that Tyler can. So he's making the safe plays here.
Floatstone DC, and that will be the end of this. And we'll go off the
game
soon.
Yes. So he's going to set up for 6 cards. Oh,
Floatstone,
it's a float.
DC.
There they are.
Yeah.
So that's going
to
be
And computer search to boot. Yeah.
Wow, that was a very short game.
Unfortunately, yeah, it happens.
That was
it happens.
Tough. Yeah, that's Pokemon for
Azul's
you sometimes.
Azul's deck is not common to do that with you know, it's quite common to see him get Lurantis 2 stage 2s in play, sometimes 3 on the first turn. And in that game, we saw 1 Shaman.
Right, yeah.
If we didn't know better, we would think that maybe he was playing a Shaman deck.
Right, I mean, Tyler technically doesn't know. Yeah, he does not know the deck yet. He knows there's grass in it, though, so he has an idea.
But you're right. He does not know.
Not specifically.
So Azul goes first now. And if Tyler doesn't get the Wobbuffet start, you could see a turn 1 Vileplume.
Right. That's what Azul wants. He wants that turn 1 Vileplume. He wants to stop Tyler from playing level balls, from playing ultra balls, getting his setup,
It's very hard, because for Wobbuffet...
At any point when the lock gets going, it's going to be really tough for Azul to break it.
Azul also depends a lot on Shamans for setup.
Right.
And, if a Wobbuffet starts, it's very hard for Azul to get a Vileplume out. It's
definitely.
Very difficult.
For sure, I mean... It could go either way, but it's going to be tough for Azul, I think. I think it's going to be really tough.
I do, too. Unfortunately, I was so excited to see Lurantis.
I want to see Lurantis in action.
But game one's down, and I still haven't seen Lurantis.
No, yeah. We may never see one. We may not see Lurantis come into play.
No, you'll see him this game for sure. That deck will not fail 2 games in a row. Mm. I believe that after something like that, the Pokemon gods will give him a little... luck, and he will...
There'll be some karma. Can't be all one-sided.
And you could see turn 1 Vileplume, turn 1 Lurantis, and maybe go to a game 3.
That would be ideal. We'd like to see a 3rd game in the series, of course. But it seems so far to me today, like, Expanded has been, like, really, really lock-heavy. Or, like, really one thing or the other.
Rock, paper, scissors?
Yeah, exactly.
We haven't seen a lot of close games.
No, I mean...
It's been... 2-0, 2-0, 2-0, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah. And it's usually been like out of like seeds, we had the toad deck. We had the
that was lopsided.
Yeah, super lopsided. We have this lock deck, two lock decks actually facing off right now. So way more lock decks in expanded than in standard for sure. Standard's definitely been moving away from that kind of style of play.
I don't know, because Decidueplume would probably be best deck in format right now, and I would consider that somewhat of a control and lock deck.
A little bit, yeah. It's not quite a full lock, though, right? It's not really like Toad, Laser, you can't move, you can't attack.
Fair enough, yeah.
I mean, it's sniping with Decidueye, and it's preventing from playing trainers, but it's not like paralyzing every single turn.
This one here, Lurantis, come on, what's he starting? It's grass, it's green. But Lurantis, right, it heals itself too, so it's so hard to knock this thing out. Yeah. Yes.
Oh boy.
Okay.
We might have a Muna start. Oh, yeah, we have a Muna start.
Well, that's good for Azul.
Yep.
And was there a supporter in there? Is that all trainers?
There's a computer search, I think.
Doesn't matter. Evolve will stop that. That's right.
That's very true.
That's a grass Pokemon supporter, active.
Supporter.
I know that. Okay, so.
What is that? I can't
it's Lurantis basic. This is what he wants to start. This is ideal for him. Okay. I can't see everything.
It's very tough to see. The camera's pretty blurry.
Battle Compressor, because he does have revitalizers in hand.
Yeah. I think that was another revitalizer. Oh, we've just
received
the Execulus, so here we go.
Yep.
Let's see.
Yeah, you want that one, do you?
I want to see what's in this deck. Oh, Fomantis. I really wanted to know the name. So Fomantis,
oh, the name of the basic?
Yeah.
So
Gloam.
It's up. It's up and going already. Now we're looking for the,
wow,
the
that
big
was
things.
Fast. I glanced away at the deck list for 1 second. I look up and we've got a Lurantis.
Well, unlike the Decidueye, it is a stage one.
Right.
Which is much easier to get into play, right?
A 210 HP stage one.
And its first attack accelerates two energies from the discard to your Pokemon in any way you like. I believe any way. Mm-hmm. Attach two basics from your discard to your... Yeah, any way you like. So, I would think that there's no disrupting this. You can remove an energy and he just brings it back.
It doesn't matter, yeah.
But this is the most important thing for Azul. Getting the Vileplume is the biggest... Oh, he's got it. He's got Battle Compressor and he's... But I don't know if he's got the Float Stone. That's the thing.
How does this deck deal with Volcanion? Would Volcanion kind of just run right through all of the...
He does not want to see Volcanion, or he wants to catch Volcanion with a hand like Tyler's now, all trainers, and hope that he can't get out and just bench him, right?
Definitely.
He does carry an AZ in hand. Oh...
Okay, so he's going to AZ a Shaymin? Maybe
yeah, he's going to AZ a Shaymin.
More.
He needs, he wants that Float Stone on Vileplume.
Yes, absolutely. He's going to draw for two. Not a lot.
But he does...
I think he got
he's got Computer Search.
Yeah.
But he does have
whatever
Vileplume.
He wants.
It's all ready to roll, because he's...
Right. So he just wants that Float Stone.
He just needs the Float Stone, yeah.
If he doesn't get the Float Stone before Vileplume becomes active, then Tyler can just Lissandra up the Vileplume, chip away at it until it's gone.
Well, it's funny how, you know, the table's turned here. Tyler has to do something next turn or it just ends. Like it... Oh, no. Sorry, Azul can't attack this turn, so he can accelerate the energies.
Turn, But he can't, So, Tyler likely has two more turns, right? No.
Yes.
How much HP does Muna have? 60. Okay, Solar Blade or Chloral Scythe.
He can do it next turn.
He can use the GX next turn and do 100 damage with Chloral Scythe.
Oh, sorry,
attack.
The GX attack. Yeah. That's right.
So, he actually can end the game next turn with one more grass attachment.
Did you see what he got off Computer Search?
No.
He just kind of whipped it out there?
Chloral Scythe. Lots to pay attention. Yeah, he kind of like put it straight to his hand. He does not have to show Tyler, and he doesn't have to show us either.
No, but usually our angle you can catch. I'm guessing it was the Float Stone.
Shaymin? Maybe it might have been a third Shaymin, I think. Well, I'm surprised he didn't get the Float Stone.
Well, the only piece he's missing is the Float Stone.
I think he didn't have another supporter, so he went with the Shaymin in hopes of drawing the Float Stone and another supporter. So kind of a greedy play, but I think a lot of the best players end up making greedy plays and being rewarded, you know?
Okay, so that's the Vileplume.
He's just going to go for it without
the
Soulstone.
We've seen that he runs AZ, so there's probably multiple copies in there.
Definitely. So it's not the end of the world since he didn't get this Bloodstone.
Now, the ball's in Tyler's court. He's got this turn to get a Pokemon out. And
he got an N. He topped deck an N. Oh, he has one in his hand.
That's all he's got. That's all he's got.
But Azul had two non-supporter cards, an energy and another card. So he did have the knockout on the Muna if Tyler didn't get another card.
Tyler actually has 14 basic Pokemon in his deck.
That's a lot.
The odds are still pretty good.
Yeah, that is
that
a lot.
That he could catch something here.
But he can't play an Ultra Ball, which is so devastating.
Correct. Unless he gets a DCE and a Wobbuffet, then he can go off.
Right. There's a Wobbuffet. There's a Shaymin.
And a Shaymin.
And another Wobbuffet. Ugh. God,
so you're
going to
see both, and you're going to see a Shaymin. I'm guessing he's Shaymin's.
He can set up for three because those Ultra Balls are unplayable, unfortunately. He has Hex Maniac in his hand for next turn.
Is that a Hex Maniac?
Yes. But he doesn't get an energy or a Shelmet, so the lock will not be happening next turn. Well, he has Force of Giant Plants, actually, so he can go...
That's true, that's true. And Excalibur can go right in, yeah.
And Tyler doesn't play Force of Giant Plants.
Oh, so he's using... He's using long-distance hypnosis?
Yeah, definitely.
And he got it. He got it.
Another thing... trying to keep the die on the table.
Oh, and he didn't wake
no.
up!
Azul's asleep.
Muna!
Oh, my goodness. But Azul doesn't play Virizion EX to help with status conditions.
No, because he's got Vileplume, so you just don't expect it.
Right.
Although
it would
help this matchup.
It
really
would. It's probably not worth teching just for this matchup, though.
So he's got to pay for retreat regardless.
Right.
So he's not attacking.
It's unfortunate that he didn't get the energy last turn.
And whatever, he's got to bring up Wob, but Wob will get one shot by Lurantis.
Right.
110 HP on Wob, I believe. 110.
Yep.
So
110, yep. So here comes the Hex Maniac. Now he can play
that's
items.
You know what? Azul put a lot of energies in the discard for that attack.
He did.
Oh, no, he has one in his hand. I just saw it.
He definitely has Super Rod in his deck
nine
either
grass.
Way, so those energy are not
nine grass.
Are not going anywhere. This is where Vileplume fails in comparison to Seismitoad because you can't play a Hex Maniac after being Quaking Punched. It doesn't
Correct.
Work the same way. You will never play items.
And you can't shut Seismitoad off with Wobbuffet.
Nope. Exactly.
Right?
Yeah, so those are the weaknesses of Vileplume that are just kind of easy to exploit. And also, since Decidueye has been such a popular deck lately,
very popular,
many decks are going to be running answers to Vileplume, such as Wobbuffet and Hex Maniac. Most players are prepared for Vileplume. Oh, is that the end of his turn?
Yeah, he couldn't do anything else.
Oh my goodness. That is rough.
You might see him leave Wob active. It's a possibility, and accelerate energies.
I think he's already past turn, right?
No,
Azul,
now,
you
right?
might allow the Wob to remain active.
Well, because he put all those energies in the discard. I know he's...
Now Azul can play trainers too, right?
Oh, he's just taking a knockout. Yeah, you're right.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't have any to play.
Yeah, it didn't really matter. Yes, and now that Wob is going to be in the active almost every turn, both players... We'll be able to play trainers, but where Lurantis differs from Seismitoad is that Lurantis has a much higher damage output than Seismitoad does. And the ability to heal itself. Yes, we froze.
We're getting a refresh.
We're coming
right
back.
Away. We're caught.
Coming back.
Now, we did see Azul did play AZ. Unfortunately, he used it on the first turn, but do you know how important that would have been for a deck and cover?
Very important.
How many did he?
How many AZ?
What is that number right there?
Four. I believe that's a four. So Azul is playing four AZ.
With Forest, they just keep coming back.
Wow, yeah, that's really, really good. That is definitely very good. He can also pick up his Vileplume at any point during the turn and play trainers. He can pick up a Pokemon that has been deck and covered. So this match may not be as favored for Tyler as maybe we thought.
Four AZ.
Yeah.
I never saw that coming.
That is quite a lot.
Wow. He also plays one Lysander, which he's already used, I believe, right? No, that was last game. No, that was last game.
Azul's playing two Lysandre.
Oh, there is. There's one in. That's right.
He also plays a Palpad.
I saw that. I wasn't going to say anything.
You were keeping that a secret?
Palpad, it's been a while, but I believe it puts two supporters.
Two supporters back to the deck, yeah.
So you could see...
Put those AZs.
AZs
going
back in there. Yeah.
Six AZ
he
for
used
this
one. He used
He's
got
to be feeling pretty unlucky that he lost the first game now, to be honest. I feel like he might be a little more prepared for this matchup than we maybe thought.
The thing is I'm shocked by seeing that, but Tyler has no idea.
No, definitely.
So we'll see if that strategy works.
With four AZ, you gotta imagine you're gonna have it in hand all the time, and he does have it right now. Tyler's has not gotten a deck and cover yet, but. So many cards in hand, and he can actually play any trainer he wants to, but chooses just to knock out the Wob.
So now Tyler...
Pretty much making all these trainers dead cards.
Tyler has no trainers now. He has no way around this.
Right, no. Only to play the Hex again, but
I
he
would
can't
not...
because it's in the discard. Oh, boy. It looks rough. Chorus.
He needs a Wob out of this. But...
Well, he plays four, you said, right? So, it's possible.
Azul is, holding onto an AZ in his hand right now. So
yep.
Don't expect him to miss a turn unless he decides to let it happen because
yeah.
Tyler can't
right.
repeat the process.
AZing this Lurantis with three energies would probably be something he doesn't really want to do.
Well, Tyler also doesn't have a backup Shelmet.
Right, but now.
And he doesn't have,
now
he just got one. I was going to say he doesn't have the ability to play level balls or
right.
anything like that.
But now he got a Wob and a Shelmet.
He's in good shape.
Yeah. The thing about sending up Wobbuffet right after a deck to cover is that it allows Azul to play trainers as well. So that's a little tricky for Tyler.
But, yeah.
He may not even want to promote the Wob directly after deck to cover.
He needs trainers to get set up again, though, right?
Right. He might want to promote the Musharna, though. Oh, he's going to promote it. Because if it gets knocked out somehow this turn, it's probably not going to happen. It's definitely not going to happen.
I don't
happen.
This is the third Wobbuffet. This is the third Wobbuffet. And we know that the AZ could come into effect. Unfortunately, Azul doesn't have any other energies in play.
Right, so he can't really AZ this. He has to just kind of hope Tyler doesn't get...
He can afford that with that
attack.
HP. He
right.
can afford to...
And he can always heal that damage away.
That's right.
He's not too concerned about it at this moment. Three level ball.
What?
Oh, man.
Oh, yeah, because Forest is still in play, right?
He's like, here I go. Yep.
He still needs a Floatstone to get back, and a DCE, of course. And he does have a Sycamore that he had got off of Forewarn last. Oh, he's got two now, though. He can Forewarn twice.
Yep, that's pretty crazy.
Can Tyler come back in this?
Can Tyler come back in this?
Like, it looked lopsided game one, but Azul... kind of has the cards to beat this.
I don't think Tyler can come back. Like, it's a little early to call it, but it seems tough.
Oh.
What Tyler's going to have to do.
Burbank City Gym in play, so the poison is very effective now.
Yeah. It's tough.
He's got a pretty thin deck. He's not going to miss a DC on this.
He can keep the lock going, but the thing is that Azul can break it pretty much anytime he wants.
He needs the energy, though.
He
might break it.
He didn't even attach again last
turn. But he might not attack.
Right.
He put a lot in the discard.
And there's no point in breaking it if he's not going to also take a prize the same turn.
Floatstone?
Yeah, he got the floatstone.
waiting.
Whoa. So
nope.
Many cards.
He didn't get the DC. But I don't know if he's used Misharna yet.
Nope, here goes
he
first
used it last
Forlorn.
Turn.
No DC here. Takes an Excelgor. Gets a second Forewarn. Oh, there it is. Last card.
Wow.
He dug so many cards deep.
Misharna.
10,
MVP.
14 cards deep.
Was
he got
it?
To dig that turn,
wow.
Yeah. The 14th card. That is pretty crazy.
Can you do the math on that for me? Where would he be at? Like, Azul's got a AZ this, no matter what. But
I can't
can
see
die,
this. Is this one?
He decking covered
one, like a one
for 50, poison,
so
60, back 70. And now
so
Burbank's in play.
So he's going to be doing...
I don't know. He might even have a muscle band. That would be great.
He's
going to
be doing 90, so...
It's not possible to get the knockout here.
He'll be doing 160. And then... 190 going back to his turn, and Lurantis will be alive.
I imagine Azul, definitely if he has an energy or top decks one, he will AZ it.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, he doesn't have one in hand. But I don't think he wants to let go of that AZ.
I'm just waiting for the top deck. That changes everything. I'm not sure what he does. He's going to have to just like throw something in the active if he doesn't get an energy.
Yeah. That's for sure.
Tyler realizes he's back in this game.
Yeah.
He's taking this very
yeah,
he's
now
very
every move he makes
right
has got to be super calculated.
Because he did not look good a turn or two ago,
no.
Right?
And that's another thing about Excelgor based decks, like whether it be this Excelgor Wob or the old version of Excelgor Gothitelle, Empoleon Excelgor,
Trevenant
Excelgor. Yeah. There's been a lot of Excelgor variants, but they all require very precise play and very good resource management.
And math.
And math, yes, math. A lot of math. So it's a pretty difficult deck to play.
Oh, he top decked the grass, that's what I said.
Oh, okay. All right, we're in business.
So I imagine he'll accelerate the energies now, but he's got to have his...
Yeah, like AZ, the Lurantis, promote the other one, attach, accelerate.
He's got a big hand. I don't know. Was there only one AZ in his hand?
I saw one.
Worried about not having enough to finish the game?
I think he's just taking his time because... I'm honestly not sure because he doesn't have a lot of time to work with, so he might be going for the tie by like making sure he wins this game. And then not going to a game 3.
Valid point. But he's definitely worried about resources, I think.
Right, he has a lot of choices he could make. He's hovering over Lissandre. But he won't be able to retreat this Lurantis.
Yeah, but Tyler would also not have
trainers.
So he's
going to bring up the Misharna.
This is what I told you was an issue.
Definitely.
It's got three retreats, so Tyler's not getting back. Unless Tyler has some sort of...
Oh, yeah, and he has to counter the Burbank in order to keep his Lurantis alive.
Tyler does have an AZ. I don't know if it's in his discard or not. We can't pick it up like as if we were playing and take a peek.
Yeah, no, we can't.
But he does have an AZ.
He's going to use Forewarn. It's a DCE and a Floatstone. I mean, Flowstone doesn't help him at all. So he's got to be thinking about whether or not he wants the DC. And he wants the Flowstone. Does he have a Sycamore in his hand?
The Flowstone's not going to help, but...
I know. He might want to discard it. I don't know. I don't know what he wants to do with that Flowstone. I can't see his hand.
Normally what you do when you're playing it is you attach the float stones that you don't need to your Xelgors to put them back in your deck.
Right, exactly.
But he's not able to play them.
No, it's not relevant. Ends up taking a DC anyway.
Wow, this has been kind of back and forth.
Yeah, I don't know what's going to happen. It's hard to call it.
Well, now Azul can heal.
Right.
We got a poison marker in
that's
play.
That's awesome. That helps for sure. Yeah, there's no way he wants to let this Lurantis go and give Tyler two prizes.
An end right now would be nice before he did that? I don't know. Tyler seems to have a lot of cards in hand.
Yes, absolutely. But Azul knows he's basically just sitting there with that Musharna.
He is.
Until Azul allows him to do something about
it. Until Azul decides to knock it out.
Yeah.
I think now's a good time to accelerate energy, but...
It's a very math-based matchup. Azul's calculating whether or not Lurantis is likely to be knocked out going into Tyler's turn. He decides to go with the AZ and the energy accelerate.
I think he's going to take his time and accelerate on both of them.
Yeah, I think that makes sense. He doesn't really want the energies anywhere else.
Well, that way if he AZs, he can still attack again.
Right, yeah. All he has to do is attach a third. He can Solar Blade for 120.
So
got a forewarn.
But Azul could possibly just do that three turns to knock it out,
mm-hmm.
and that would be three more turns that's in the active position.
Right. Yeah.
I don't know deck sizes though. Both of these decks are famous for thinning out very quickly.
I think they both have a reasonable amount. It looks like they both have a decent amount left.
Azul's down there, I can tell you that. That is a very small deck.
Oh, yeah, I see it now, yeah.
I can almost count how many
in there.
Yeah, I
can see that one. So I think Azul definitely has less than Tyler.
I think
so.
He just
can't be going for a deck out. You can never deck out at Xelgor, right? For the most part.
No, you can. Well, you can.
If you leave this Musharna in here forever.
If you can stop them.
If you literally
from...
leave it forever. But I don't think he has that option because I do think his deck is less than Tyler's.
I'm curious what the play is here. Oh, he's doing it again.
Oh, you can attach him in any way you like, including to the active. That seems pretty good.
That's the right move because he might end up having to AZ that one after he breaks lock here and Wob starts coming in.
Yeah.
It keeps going back and forth, Nicolina. I'm. I don't want to try to pick the winner
of this game.
Every game so far is like,
Oh my goodness.
Seismitoad versus Volcanion, and then
a little bit of a
this
fest here, but
well, Xelgor is normally the favorite in this, but four AZs and a Pal Pad on top of that makes things much different. Because he accelerates energy, you're never gonna run out of energy.
That's for sure. Oh god, I remember when this deck also played Dusknoir.
Yes.
that was an extremely complicated deck. It's funny now seeing this more like streamlined.
I think it was easier, wasn't it? Because you would just move all the damage, you would keep one person active.
Yeah, definitely.
And then
but
you would
it was much harder
everything.
To set up.
Yes, very hard to set up. You needed Tropical
Beach.
Right,
this seems very easy to set up.
We haven't seen any Tropical Beaches today.
No, yeah.
The junior,
there's not enough time.
The junior that I gave Xelgor to, it has two Tropical Beaches
in
it. Yeah.
It seems like the format's mostly too fast for Tropical Beach, especially with Night March being a thing.
Except lock decks, right? I mean, a lock deck's a lock deck.
It's even a fast lock deck, though. Azul got the lock, Vileplume lock turn one. Tyler would get the Xelgor turn two.
And a Wobbuffet start on turn one.
Yeah.
Right? No Shamans for you.
Right, exactly. So lock decks have really sped up.
Is that two AZs I saw there? Like, I'm really trying to squeak because their hands are so big that it's hard to tell.
It's hard to tell.
What their options
that means
are.
One.
The one.
It looks like just one. No, two. It's two.
Is it two?
It's two.
So he gets the knockout with accelerating energy right now. So, what? He's going to use one to draw cards.
Man. He wants to play Shaman? No, he just doesn't want Shaman on the bench. He wants another Fomantis.
Oh, so he can keep AZing and attacking.
Yeah, I like that.
So he's down to three prizes. If he had three set up, he could AZ and attack each time.
Yeah.
Does he have that many AZs?
He only has one more in his hand. Without... I mean, he could always... I don't know.
See, this is the thing where when you're playing, you're constantly looking at your opponent's resources.
Right.
It's much harder. I can see Abzul does have Palpat, so...
Right.
While
he has to AZ.
While if it's active, he's gonna pal pad.
Yeah, he has to AZ the Vileplume. Or while if he leaves it active. Yeah. So he could, if Tyler leaves Vileplume active, he can pal pad. But if he doesn't, Azul will have to AZ Vileplume and then pal pad after that. And then put Vileplume back down.
I'm not sure we'll see pal pad ever again on stream this week.
Yeah, it doesn't seem likely.
Azul, yeah.
At this point, Azul has to finish this game up within the next 14 minutes, or we're looking at a 1-0.
I wasn't even looking at the time.
I'm always looking
at
that.
Well, no, you know what? At this, he's got two energies on the...
Yeah, I think it looks likely for this game
total.
To finish.
Was there any left in the discard?
I don't know.
Well, essentially, he would have two energies left in his deck, so he could AZ and attack every single turn now and knock something out.
Right, so I think he's pretty set up to win. And Tyler's deck is pretty much a one-trick pony, so it's just going to deck and cover. It's pretty much the only thing it can
do. That's right.
Do.
That's right.
It's only option.
That kind of good.
Yeah, it prevents the...
Forest, there's no quick evolving.
Yeah.
But
it doesn't matter. Wob is in the active. He doesn't have to AZ the Vileplume.
Oh, wait a minute. Why...
So it doesn't matter.
Why is he not paralyzed?
He should be, and poisoned. Yeah, I think he might be telling him that he's paralyzed, maybe.
Did he sky return?
Oh, man. He has three cards, or four.
No, he did.
Three cards,
50,
or four in deck?
Yeah, he deck and covered, but there's no poison marker, and he's not paralyzed.
I think they're just keeping a sloppy game state.
Three
or
cards.
I think Azul might plan
three
on...
Three cards left in his
deck.
Yeah,
I know. So it's, Azul might plan on AZing this anyway, so maybe he's not too concerned about the poison marker and the paralysis.
I'm keeping an eye on that.
There we go.
That a boy, Azul.
Got that figured out. Now just to put the poison marker on it.
Yeah, just in case, to make sure he takes the damage. Although, I don't think that he's staying there. I think that you're going to see a knockout here. And he's got one more energy in hand, so you know he's guaranteed two prizes for sure.
He has to take... I mean, he gets one prize, right? Unless he can knock out a Shaman for his last two. But.
Now, I truly expected when Palpat came down that Tyler would pick it up and read it. I would.
No, he remembers
Nicolina,
it.
I would read it. I would. It's still even.
I remembered it even.
Did you play it?
No, I never played it.
Neither did I.
No. I know some people played it. They liked it in Darkrai.
Before Via Seekers?
Yeah. Or they played it in Evil Toll. I was never a fan of the card, though.
It seems very good in this deck.
Yeah.
Because Via Seekers aren't as strong here.
In an aggressive
deck, though.
It's not good for me. But yeah, it definitely seems good in this deck.
AZ. Attach to the other one. Evolve it. And you're going to see Wob go down. And I don't know if Tyler's got a replacement. but he's already got the DCE in play with
the
Acelgor.
Ready to go. The thing about it is that Azul cannot ace Z and Lissandre in the same turn. So he's going, if he's paralyzed every turn, he's going to have to take three single prizes.
With 10 minutes left in the game.
Right.
Yeah, he's got to attach there.
So he's not really going to have a chance to Lissandre that Shaman for the last two prizes.
It's getting out of the wire. Nicolina, I don't know how to pick this game. You just saw...
I really don't know.
You just saw Tyler, you know, bench him on game one, and now Tyler hasn't seen a prize card.
Yeah, it's insane. I actually think Azul's deck seems to be favored here. But, yeah, the time is a factor.
Azul's taking a long time, and Tyler's not arguing about that, right?
Yep, definitely.
So now... I believe that was the third Wob.
Yeah, it was. So there's one more.
Was it the third Wob?
Yeah. It was at least the third.
What else did Azul knock out?
Because
he's got four prizes.
I think, was it a Musharna?
You're right. It was the Musharna that he locked active.
He did have
so
two.
There's one more Wobbuffet in the deck.
Yep.
And I'm pretty sure that I saw it in his hand at one point where he didn't have a bench spot to put it.
Yes.
And there it is.
Yes, there it is. Yeah. It's funny, Azul has answers for Tyler. Tyler has answers for Azul. It's just which deck can cancel out the other one better.
What do you think's gonna happen here?
Oh man,
I think a deck and cover.
I think we might see a deck and cover. Like, hopefully, Tyler wants to accompany it with an end, but end deck and cover. Oh, he hex maniacs, huh? It's interesting. Probably not too effectual right now.
No. You're right.
Doesn't really
do much.
The
N, the 2.
Yeah.
But Azul's deck is so small right now.
Oh, yeah. Is he trying to deck him out here? I mean, that would also be assuming Azul doesn't have an N, but Azul only plays one.
He needs... Yeah. He needs those
If we
lobs.
See a deck out here, oh, man. Kind of using up his resources, getting
like
everything out of his deck. Yeah.
They can never, never deck out because they put three cards back in every time, and that's two if it's Mew, right?
Right. It's like an endless loop. If the deck gets to the point where it's supposed to, every other card is gone, and you shuffle in your three Exalgor DCE. Shum it to an empty deck.
It's one of my favorite decks of all time, Exalgor Wob. It's more pleasurable to play than to watch.
It's pretty
or
horrible
play
to play against.
That's right. But playing
it's honestly used to be the bane of my existence. Even Keldeo doesn't really win you the game against it because they can just Lissandre up the Keldeo. Start deck covering into the Keldeo.
Oh, 100%. As soon as Keldeo hits there.
Yeah, you need
and
two.
And they can't even rush in anyway because of Wobbuffet.
Oh, now,
right?
Nowadays, yeah. That's the old version where you could get around it with two Keldeo. But, yeah, now you can't even do that. So it's actually more of a lock now than it was.
That was with the Trevenant, right?
Yep. Or even the Empoleon version or any other version.
I don't remember Empoleon, though. I remember Flygon.
Oh, yeah, and Flygon, though. There was an Empoleon version.
Had
consistency because both players really tended to fill up their bench, and also diving draw would really let you find your Exalgors and DCs.
Right. Was that, how many is that? I didn't get a good four, five? You spread them out?
Looks like four.
Tyler searching for his Bunnelby.
Oh my gosh.
I'm only joking. I wish he had one there.
Bunnelby tech secret.
I don't know. I can't seem to get a look at it, but it looked like four cards. So, deck out's not going to happen.
Four or five, yeah.
You have 5 minutes? There's no way he's going to have five turns in 5 minutes.
Definitely not. No way. Oh, my goodness. Beauclair's really taking their time on this.
Yeah, but Azul's got to pick it up here, right?
Yeah.
Tyler's okay with a tie here.
Yeah. Well, Tyler wants a win here. Hoping this game does not finish. Now Azul's thinking about playing the AZ.
I think he has to. At this point, you have to take your two prizes.
Yeah, you can't let this go.
You have to.
But then how will he ever get another prize?
That's right. He's trying to figure out how he's going to get his last prize.
It is tough. We might even see Tyler just winning this game. Despite him not having taken a prize yet. And honestly, Excalibur decks often do that, right? They go down to a very deep prize deficit, and then just when you think they're about to lose, you find yourself in a situation where you can't win against it.
You're absolutely right. When you're playing against it, you run out of resources trying to answer it every time.
Yeah.
And it's... I find like Tyler would probably agree that it's like you're walking on pins and needles playing the deck until you know your opponent's out of resources. Their VS Seekers are gone,
exactly.
Any switches.
Just like, how can I survive until I can cycle this unbreakable lock?
And when some people get in a groove and they break lock over and over, right?
Yep.
And they take prizes and you start worrying, but if you can weather the storm, Excalibur Wobbuffet is one of the most annoying decks you'll ever see in the Pokemon trading card game, right?
For sure. It has to be one of the top most hated decks. That and Nightmarch.
Well, you know, if I was to ever make a ban list for the TCG, Excalibur would be on my list, right?
I would ban that too. I agree. That would go straight.
I don't
want it
being banned. Let's make no mistake,
because
it's one of my favorite cards.
Yeah.
But I'm saying, like,
it makes the game no fun.
It's a very powerful card.
Yeah.
Maybe too powerful.
Mm-hmm. I agree. Oh boy, this is exciting to watch. A lot of discard searching. Oh man.
But
the time is ticking.
Time is ticking. We're, you know, Azul's got two prizes still to get. Although, you know, Tyler actually has nothing in his deck that could take a hit.
That
could survive a hit.
That's why he just has to paralyze and poison. I think time is up for the regular round. So
that's time in the regular round.
Not quite for this round.
I just heard an alarm. That's time in regular rounds, but I believe our clock is accurate.
Yes, it should be.
And you know, what's the maximum time you're allowed?
What, 50 minutes?
No, like, I'm not saying there's any stalling here, but Tyler's not gonna rush, and Azul doesn't seem like he's. Azul's got to figure out that he's got to rush soon.
Yeah.
I don't know if he's wearing a watch or not.
He doesn't look like he is, but they had to have just heard time get called for the round.
Tyler is wearing a watch, and there's no way that that's coincidence.
Yeah. I mean, he knew what he had to do. He got lucky to win that first game. He had to make this game take as long as possible. And yeah, I think it's 30 seconds per action is the time limit rule.
He's got the DCE. So Azul's going to have to take a very fast turn here. It's going to have to be very fast.
Right.
But he's going to have to play that AZ.
No, it's not happening.
And then he's going to hope that...
I mean, they're going to go into +3 as well, so...
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. So Azul could have two extra turns.
Oh, he got the knockout there with the muscle band. Oh.
Yeah.
Was that right?
I didn't see how much... With the Verbank,
That was... So that AZ now...
Well, this is actually good for Azul, because it gives him an opening to take a prize here.
But he's also got...
That's why he wanted to bench that other Fomantis.
He's got Revitalizer in hand.
Yep, so he's going to get a new one, accelerate to it, take a knock... Well,
he's not
going to
accelerate.
You're right,
he
can't
accelerate.
Oh.
And also, he's low on energy. I think that's his last energy.
Oh, boy.
So if he has to AZ this active
Man.
I don't think Like, he's thinking about it now. Like, I have to accelerate energy or I'm screwed, right?
It's very, like, it's very close. He's off by one energy and or one turn.
He can take this prize here. But if that's his last energy, he has to accelerate.
Right. And he may not have time. There's 5 seconds left, and they're going into plus three.
Although, if he knocks this out, Tyler is trainer locked again, or item locked again.
They should be in plus three. This would make Azul turn zero.
We do have a die at the table for that, did we not?
Okay,
so Azul's turn zero?
Should be. I mean, if our timer here on the screen is correct. I think so, yeah. Yep, there we go, turn zero.
I think he takes a knockout, and then he's not trainer locked. So even if he gets decking covered, he's got to be decking covered under trainer lock.
Right. Yep, that's for sure.
Well, realistically, he has to anyway.
Yeah.
If Tyler decking covers now, the game's over.
You would
Am
think
I right?
so. I would think so, yeah. You know, I don't think there's anything
there's
else.
There's no way
that
of him winning, and that would be a game. So, 0-1, he's got one turn. If he AZs,
yeah,
he's got no energy.
He can't do anything.
Right?
Yeah. Yep, I believe that's it. Unless Tyler
promotes. Oh, he's got another
Wob,
too.
But I don't think he should. But I don't know. It probably still doesn't make a difference.
No, there's no energy left.
Completing actions that don't make a difference in the outcome of the game.
I could be wrong. There could be another energy in play, but he still can't take a knockout.
And that's his last turn. So.
And that's his last turn.
Ooh, all of a sudden, max elixir we didn't know about. No, there's no max elixir. There's no energy acceleration besides flower supply.
That's right, and it only does 40
and it's
damage.
Not,
right.
So how much HP does Shellman have? 60?
60.
Yeah,
there's nothing that he can
knock out.
Anything,
yeah.
And now he might not even have the AZ anyway.
Yeah. I think it's over for Azul.
It is. As far as I know, it's over regardless. It's over unless he does a center lady or something, which is not in his deck.
Nope. there's nothing in his deck he can do.
And looked very slim or very grim for Tyler, but Tyler's going to take this win, and that's game.
Well, Tyler didn't deck and cover, did he? Oh, but
he didn't
over.
Have to.
Yeah,
he's last
matter.
Turn. And
it's over.
Yeah.
Wow. Wow, that was a very long, very.
It was not exciting to watch, and I was really excited about Lurannis, but
I
wasn't.
I don't know about that.
Wobbuffet is the most annoying deck, like.
Right, that matchup was something else. Hopefully, everyone in chat all stayed awake for that.
What are you gonna do now, Tyler? Deck and cover?
Yeah. Oh, God, I hate Exelgore decks. I'm sorry. That's your favorite deck, but I really hate it.
It's not that it's my favorite. Let's not... Like, I shouldn't say favorite. It's not... If I was to play today, I would have played that deck.
Right, yes.
Unfortunately.
You know that it's good.
It's good with this meta right now, in my opinion.
Yeah, definitely. And it's definitely
was
an
that
underused...
painful to watch?
Yes, extremely. I'm going to go out and say yes. But... You know, it's still a legitimate strategy, and it's one that Tyler recognized as being really powerful going into today's tournament. So, props to him for having the willpower and the stamina to go through, play that deck every round.
We think alike.
Cover
we
a
think
million
alike.
Times.
Yeah.
I mean, he's
do?
A true champion, right? Yeah.
He
he's
got that. I wonder how his whole day's been going. I wonder what he's faced and how he's handled these.
I
because
know. Yeah.
As you've seen, it's a very tedious deck to play as well. Like, you need to get all these pieces. And
yep, all the pieces. You need to be willing to take a hit, and then you come back. And then you make it. It's just about making the game unwinnable for your opponent.
But the
it's not about winning the game. It's just about making the game unwinnable for your opponent.
You're absolutely right. And
it's pretty crazy.
Sometimes you take your opponent right out. Game one, you did not see an attack. He deck and covered and the game was over. Yeah. He deck and covered twice and the game was over.
Yeah, I mean, even if that second game were the first game, I think he would have ended up winning it if the game kept going.
He won it.
Yeah.
Well, no.
He didn't take all the prizes.
He can't AZ as long as he...
Right.
Yeah, he can't AZ.
No, he ran out of energy. He just didn't have enough to deal with that many one-prize knockouts.
But genius four AZs.
I know. The four AZ was so close. It almost got there, but not quite. Not quite. But,
Maybe hopefully. I should go see if he's interested in talking to
yeah,
us.
Yeah, we should bring Tyler over for an interview.
All right, I'm going to go see if I can get a hold of Tyler and see if he can explain his deck and cover strategy to us.
Yes, you will get some insight on the deck and cover.
All right, guys, I'll talk to you soon.
See you soon.
Hey, we're back with the winner from last round, Tyler Turner. Excelgor Wobbuffet.
Yes, Excelgor
Wobbuffet. Please explain why you chose this annoying deck for this tournament.
That is definitely one way to describe it. The weeks prior, I was heavily testing Sableye Garbodor and Archie's Blastoise.
Okay.
Archie's Blastoise has been one of my favorite decks in Expanded. And then, you know, all this, Plume hype and Decidueye and Lurantis, and I was like, you know, maybe Blastoise is not that great of a play, and also, like, Item Lock, and I'm like...
And Wobbuffets.
And turn one gets this, and I'm like...
And turn one gets this.
Blastoise isn't going to cut it this time. And then see, like, Garbodor, you know, you kind of have the same problem. You run a lot of items, and, like, gets this, like, can hurt you a lot. And, you know, Item Lock, if you don't get a Flowstone out of Trubbish before they Item Lock you, and you're going to have trouble, like, discarding things. And...
My question for you is, you know, you've... We just watched a game go to time. You got two games in. And you basically took it to time, and it's not that you won the game, it's just you made sure he didn't win the game, okay?
Yeah.
How has your previous games gone?
First round today, I faced a Turbo Darkrai.
Okay, fair enough, a Turbo Darkrai.
Yeah, played no, like, Dragons, Salamence, Giratina, okay. So it was a lot easier to deal with. Second round, I faced...
In the first round, did you go to three games? Or did you win two?
Oh, I won the first two.
You won the first two, done.
Okay.
Okay.
All my matches today have only been two rounds.
So you've won...
I've never went to a third game yet.
That's incredible. That's incredible. You should feel fortunate for that, yeah?
Yeah. Second was Yveltal Maxi's. And I think his Archaeops was prized the first game, but
it doesn't really affect.
Yeah, because Wobbuffet. So like even then it's like, and I think he scooped earlier game too because he was like drawing dead and I had such a good board position and maybe he wanted to go get food or something, I don't know. And then the one before this one was Toad Decidueye.
That's harder, I would think. When you started the game and I said to Nicolina, because I was used to the Decidueye match, not the Lurantis, don't put Masharna down, Tyler. Don't put Masharna down because it's Lysander bait and then they'll just Decidueye you. But I wasn't.
I knew my one AZ was in deck. That's
right,
why I was
okay,
like,
fair enough.
I
was
like,
had it.
I was
had
like, because like when he had it there, then eventually I'm like, I'm just gonna wait until I draw an AZ or he kills the Masharna.
But he can't do that. Where Decidueye will leave him.
Oh yeah,
and
yeah,
they'll
yeah,
just
yeah.
Pick apart
if it was
just
Decidueye, then I probably would have been a little bit more cautious. But.
Well, I congratulate you, Tyler. Well played. Right,
thank you.
Keep it rolling.
I'm gonna
see
try
you again. Let's
I'm gonna
see you
try.
Tomorrow,
hopefully.
Right?
Hopefully.
Good luck, my friend.
All right, thank you.
Thanks.